Hello friends, I'm Kunal Gupta from Gate Lectures. As I told you earlier that we have started a new series of notification of government jobs, PSUs or any another anonymous body. Today, we are going to talk about the DSSSB exam which will be going to come after few days. What is DSSSB? Delhi Subordinate Services Selection Board. DSSSB is having recruitment of PGT computer science mail post which is having code 150/17. DSSSB is also having recruitment of PGT computer science for female post which is having code 151/17. Basically, this post is related to teaching in computer science. The application for online registration can be filled between 5th of Jan 2018 till 31st of Jan 2018. After few days, this application portal will be going to open for you all. Total number of vacancies for male are 98 for computer science post and for female it is 99 for computer science post. DSSSB also offers the position of educator and the pay scale will be in between rupees 9,300 to 34,800 plus. Grade pay will be 4,800 in Group B. Now, what is the eligibility criteria for BE or BTech computer science or IT plus postgraduate diploma in computer application or B or C level diploma from DOEC? Ministry of Communications and IT plus 1 year teaching experience is needed, or MSc in Computer Science or MCA plus 1 year teaching experience, or Master of Engineering or MTech in Computer Science or IT. You should have any of these equivalent qualification get eligible for this exam. Now, what is the age limit? Age limit for the candidates who belongs to SC or SG is having extension of age of 5 years for OBC, 3 years for physically handicapped, 10 years for physically handicapped plus SC or SG, 15 years for physically handicapped plus OBC is 13 years. But keep a note in mind that the candidate must be a citizen of India only. The education qualification, age, experience, etc. as stipulated in advertisement shall be determined as on the closing date of submissions of application. For Kashmiri migrant teachers, one-time relaxation in the upper age limit for the number years served as teacher in the Department of Education up to 5 years and 10 years for SC or ST and 8 years for OBC candidate, up to 5 years for meritorious sports person, period of military service plus 3 years for ex-service man, group C and B non-gets it, 45 years, 50 years for SC or ST, 48 years for OBC and 45 years for disabled defense services personnel who is in group C. Up to the age of 35 years for widows or divorced women, women judicially separated and who are not remarried for group C post, and 40 years for SC and ST and 38 years for OBC. Now, how to apply? Candidates who want to apply for this teaching post can apply online on online application registration system from 5th of Jan 2018 to 31st of Jan 2018 at the official website, that is www.dssbonline.nic.in. For read detailed advertisement number 4/17 before online application and check official website of DSSSB. Now, coming to the application fee. Application fee for this paper is only 100 rupees. SC, ST, PH, women candidates and ex-servicemen are exempted from payment of application. Ex-servicemen who have already secured employment in civil side under central government on regular basis after availing of the benefits of reservation given to ex-servicemen for their re-employment are not eligible for fee concession. The candidates submitting their application online should pay the request fees only through SBI ePay. Other mode of payment will not be considered and the application of such candidate will be rejected outrightly and payment made shall stand forfeited. Last but not the least, fees one paid will not be refunded under any circumstances. Some important things to keep in mind. Candidates must apply online only. No other mode of application shall be accepted. The successful candidates will be required to submit legible self-attested copies of the documents, admit card, along with the hard copy of printout of online application form at the time of verification of documents. The centers for holding the examination will be in Delhi only. The candidate must carry Aadhaar card to the examination center, failing which they shall not be allowed to appear for the examination. Basically, you should all have your Aadhaar card, your PAN card, your admit card and the documents for the verification so that you don't have to face trouble during your exam. Mode of selection. The selection shall be made through one tier and two tier examination scheme and skill test wherever applicable. Now what will be the exam pattern? Test will be conducted in the written form only. There will be two type of exam. First, which is tier 1 and second, which will be tier 2. In tier 1, there will be total number of questions 200. And total duration will be 300 minutes. Whereas in tier 2, total number of questions will be 60 and total duration will be 180 minutes. Note, pattern given above is on the basis of the previous year and can be changed according to the official website. Now, what will be the marking scheme? There will be negative marking as applicable and deduction of 0.25 marks will be made for each wrong MCQ answer. The board reserves its right to prescribe a minimum cutoff mark for any post as per availability of candidates. Candidates numbering 6 to 10 times of vacancies will be called for Tier 2 examination subject the number of vacancies or applicants. Another one, skill test or endurance test will be taken as per requirement of the job. In Tier 2 examinations, Tier 1 exam to be used for shortlisting only. Selection will be made on the basis of marks obtained in Tier 2 examination. You should stay cautious. From which things, the vacancies advertised are provisional and liable to vary. The board reserves the right to reject the candidature of any ineligible candidate at any stage of recruitment. The board reserves the right to cancel a part of entire process of examination or a part of it due to administrative reasons and in case of unfair means, cheating or other irregularities, malpractice noticed by the board. The board reserves the right to cancel any center of exam and ask the candidates of that center to appear at another center. If any candidate uses offensive, abusive, foul language, obscene pictures, he or she will be liable for necessary penal action under relevant provision of the IT Act. In case if you want to contact someone, you can contact here to the Controller of Exam, Delhi Subordinate Services Selection Board DSSSB, The building number is FC18, Institutional Area, Karkaduma, near Railway Reservation Center. PIN code is 110092 and the telephone number is 0112237309. Friends, you can subscribe for our video lectures on YouTube, or for any further query, you can contact us on 9821876102/04. This is last two digits. Thank you.